Come sit with me. I want to talk. And cuddle.
What did we talk about? Damn this fallible memory of mine. The most comfortable spot in the cabin. Well, along with the bed, of course. I can imagine her cuddling up to me even now. Putting her hand under my shirt.
Somebody is in love. So much in love.
Of course, we made love here, too. There was no place in the cabin we didn't before things deteriorated.
Interesting. But that was TMI. Just little TMI.
The most comfortable spot in the cabin. Well, along with the bed, of course. I can imagine her cuddling up to me even now. Putting her hand under my shirt.
Interesting collection of books.
Wisdom and happiness in this bookcase. My life would have been much poorer without all this.
Only with vocabulary.
The smell of books is intoxicating. What happens to wood pulp as it ages gives it a distinctive vanilla smell.
Oh shit.
I loved it when we took down one of my favorites and curled up on the bed to read together. The wind howled outside on cold winter nights. Most of the books are mine, but all of hers are still here, too. A lot of rarities and special editions here. Sharing meals with a good red wine was one of the great pleasures in our relationship, especially in the intimacy of this cabin. Face feel hazy and distant, like remnants of a broken dream.
Now, sometimes if you actually stand here long enough, he starts talking to himself more and more and more.
Somewhere in here, in our private refuge, must be something that reminds me of her. I should probably eat. Can't remember the last time I ate. I don't feel hungry. I have more pressing things on my mind right now than culinary exploits.
You just pronounced it culinary? It's culinary, you morons! Epic face palm of doom.
The stove looks like something from World War I.
Probably has been there since World War I.
Considering how basic and ancient the kitchen is, it's a wonder what we managed to do with it from time to time. Well, she, mostly. She made this with her own hands. She was really good.
Look what I made, hun, in case we ever need to sweep something under the carpet. See the pattern of yellow squares? It's from this rug I remembered from my nursery. I must have been like 3 or 4, but it always stuck with me.
No trap door under there. There's more creaky floor. I always resisted the temptation to sweep things under there when it was my turn to tidy up.
The rug's all crooked again. Can you help me straighten it out?
No trap door under there. Just more creaky floor.
Okay, sit here. Bed.
Our refuge from the world. A place of warmth and passion.
Indeed it is.
Sometimes we joked we needed to be so far out in the woods because that's how our sex life was. Far out.
Hippies, damn you.
Furniture came with the cabin, but the bedclothes we brought with us. A place like this needs some luxury. But without her.
All you need is a blanket and a pillow and you're good. No one cares about anything else.
There are no monsters. I guess they're all in my head.
How do you know? How do you deduce this, oh Sherlock?
I feel too restless to sleep right now.
Okay, let's see. Let's go over here.
Quite a large armoire for our admittedly Spartan needs. She uses most of it. all have our skeletons in the closet. Not Serena. She's perfect.
I doubt it. No one's perfect. No one is perfect.
I'm not sure why, but I don't feel like opening it. The sole thought of it drains what little energy I have left in me. Maybe later. There's nothing of interest inside the closet anyway.
Maybe there is, maybe there isn't. You don't know. You don't know. You just don't know. These, the bottom, in here either. Eric Jerky then.
For some reason, light bulbs wouldn't last long in this lamp. I never looked into it. 2 days, 3 days tops, and bam, a brand new light bulb would burn out.
Probably because it's overpowering the bulb?
Whenever her lamp didn't work, Serena would come by my side to read. A few moments later, she would lay her head down on my chest and fall asleep. The only reason this lampshade gathered less dust than the other one was that we had to keep putting new bulbs in this one. Because of a wiring problem, or whatever, this one always starts smelling sharply of metal after being on for a while.
That's not good.
Considering what a strong odor of metal this one gives off when in use, I guess we were lucky never to have an accident. The only reason this lampshade gathered less dust than the other one was that we had to keep putting new bulbs in this one.
Flares. Found some flares. Flares.
All things of nature. I remember her long walks out in the woods.
Walkies, yeah, walkies. I don't know.
Curiously, we never brought many plants inside the cabin. We were surrounded by so many outside. I guess we were saturated by them.
Saturated indeed. I mean, give me all that pollen. Just saturate me with your pollen. Okay. I'm good.
Maybe I should have let her bring some plants inside. She liked them a lot.
There's plants right here. Okay.
A plant is a plant. Beautiful to some, boring to others. They say these things are alive. If they are, it must be a horrible existence.
Only because you're a higher state of consciousness than plants are, and they probably don't agree with you.
We have much more interesting things than this plant inside the cabin. Like my books.
Someone likes their books a little too much.
She's fairly religious. Not me. I'm the cold and cynical bastard. But I don't remember that ever being an issue between us. She always thought our relationship was less than no longer the cynical asshole, I guess.
Well, no, because when you're in love, shit happens.
Her faith came as a surprise to me. She was never prudish about sex, so I just didn't expect it.
Not all Christians are prudish about sex, okay? They're just not.
No, I don't want to read right now. Especially not a Bible.
Let's see. Let's go back over here. And go on this side. What do you got here?
It's a beautiful day. Though there's an unnatural calm surrounding the area. I've always loved the hazy afternoon shades of this place. It's deep into summer, so there's a few hours left until it gets dark. The sunlight is so bright here. In other circumstances, this
would be nice to... You know, I still think it would be nice to go out and live in the woods, just get away from people.
There's a crack in this window from a tantrum she threw some time ago. It wasn't the only thing she threw. Not exactly perfect sound.
Indeed. Wonder what she threw.
Sunlight.
Her voice.
Confusing. Oppressive. As if pregnant with some ill omen.
I don't have...
Stress. Why am I catching up with
it? Just realized I don't have a shadow. Why don't I have a shadow? This doesn't make sense.
Sunlight is so bright here. In other circumstances, this would have been the perfect afternoon for us.
It's in here. Ooh.
They prevent my blood pressure from skyrocketing. Doctor's orders. And Serena's. I'm generally not fond of taking medication. I find it hard to believe ingesting a few chemicals would do me much good in the long run.
Butter will help you keep your shit in order.
Don't forget your pill, hon. I know you'd rather not, but you know it's for the best.
Beta blockers. I have high blood pressure. I'm only supposed to take these before meals. Not a big fan of them. They do tend to alleviate my headaches, though.
Which is the point of beta blockers. They bring your blood pressure down so that you don't have headaches. That's their use. That's what they're supposed to do.
Beta blockers. I have high blood pressure. Hers. I used it, too, when shaving. There's only an outhouse, and for some reason, whoever erected the rickety thing didn't think to include wall-to-wall mirrors. So, this came in handy.
Most outhouses don't, especially if they're old cabins.
Should I dust for fingerprints? I might if I were in a detective story. After all these years, it permanently smells of her and her perfume. The last thing I need now is to see myself in the mirror. This looks awful. There's dust on this, too. It's everywhere. After all these years, it permanently smells of her and her perfume.
Aw, such love.
There's a strand of blonde hair in the comb. Yes, blonde hair like sun rays. I'm remembering.
Oh, shocker. You're remembering shit.
What's wrong with my memory? Did I have a stroke? She also had a brush, and I can't see it anywhere. Nor some of her other personal items. It's just a regular comb bought from the supermarket, new enough to still have all its teeth.
That humming is a little creepy.
These keys are for the cabin and the car.
Didn't know the car had dungeon-style keys for it. Interesting.
If the keys are here, does she have her spare? She should probably stay here in case she doesn't. Did she even have her own spare? We also have a key for the outhouse, but can't be bothered to keep it anywhere other than under that rock next to the thing. No one comes here anyway. We did have a night prowler once who left a mark inside the outhouse. We rarely lock it anyway. I never noticed it before, but there's some rust on the ring. Get a new one.
Why? If there's some rust on it, let there be rust on it, or clean it off.
We also have a key for the outhouse, but can't be bothered to keep it anywhere other than under that rock next to the thing. No one comes here anyway.
As far as you know. Let's see. Let's go back out. Here.
Dearest, how do I say any of this? I like your way with words, but if I don't write this, I don't know what I'll do. My life feels so unreal now, dreamlike, but wonderfully so. Let me try, even if clumsily. The hours I spent with you when we last met are precious to me. I was so lost such a short time ago. Everything seemed drained of color and feeling. I think we were meant to find each other, to bring meaning to our lives again, make sense of the confusion shrouding both of us.
Sweet.
When we stepped into the crystal silence of the snowy woods, away from the chatter of the guests, all nature seemed expectant, as if holding its breath, witnessing a rare moment of something infinitely better than what life in the ordinary run of things has to offer. Do you remember how the light crust of the snow glittered in the reflected light of the country house, How the copse of trees in which we walked was haloed with a magical aura. I felt the chill of the night air, and you opened your coat and enfolded me in your arms, and we hugged tight, sharing the warmth, sharing the only thing any of us have to share on this earth when you think about it.
You say you have a lack of your way of words, yet you freaking write in the way of an author would when trying to do anything. That, yeah.
Me thinks you're lying.
And then you toppled us on the snow, you devil. We laughed and rolled around, my head already spinning from the wine and crisp, pure night air and the stillness all around. We lay back and I gasped when I realized what I was seeing. The luminous starscape, like a vast velvet cloth sprinkled with powdered sugar, like it can only be seen in the countryside. I had tears in my eyes when I turned to you and we kissed, and it felt like the only moment in all of time, or outside time, and ours was the only spark that could ignite the universe. You gave me these moments. You complete me in ways I never knew to dream of. Let me be the one who makes sense of the confusion whenever you feel lost again. We can make our own world against the rest of the world if need be. Together we can silence all the demons, heal all the wounds. I love you. In eternity yours, Serena.
Oh my. It was so sweet. I almost got diabetes on it. Oh my god. Almost getting teary-eyed there a little bit. Might be blushing a little bit.
Am I blushing? Am I? Can't tell.
Anyway.
It's been so long since I said her name out loud. I think that's the moment I fell in love with her. And she told me the soothing sound of her name.
So glad to meet you. My name is Serena.
Commune Evidence, Serena's favorite perfume. I've always told Serena that she doesn't need to wear perfume. Her presence is magical enough already.
Aw, how sweet!
It smells so elegant. There's violet leaf and silk tree blossom, I think. This perfume is perfect for Serena. Why didn't I ever notice?
Because it's perfume, no one really does.
We were happy for a long time. At least, I think we were. But as time passed, we fought about every little thing, even this. I keep looking at her things, remembering all the good and bad.
Indeed.
Depends on how you look at it. Either a wonderful sensory stimulant, an aphrodisiac, or a subtle weapon in the mating rituals of Homo sapiens.
Both? I call for both. Oh, yeah.
We were happy for a long time. At least, I think we were. But as time passed, we thought
look,
the clock is a trophy from our flea market adventures. Chalk this particular purchase up to every cabin needs one.
Not that kind of clock.
Ticking begins to feel homey after a while. The first night was a nightmare, though. Time never mattered much to us while we were hiding from the rest of the world here. As long as we were together and happy. The clock has always been rather autonomous. No matter how many times we wound it up, it keeps going out of sync.
That's because something's wrong with it and needs to be repaired.
Actually, I think it might have gone out of sync again.
Probably.
No trusting this clock. I wonder what time it is. As if it mattered.
Let's see, it looks like it is 12:15.
The clock has always been rather autonomous. No matter how many times we've wound it up, it keeps going out of sync. Unlike its sibling, this lamp would last for months.
Like it's supposed to.
We brought the lamps with us when we got this place all those years ago. They were from a garage sale. The sun is streaming through the window. No reason to turn this on. All these metaphors and similes in my head. Light of my life. Make light. That's another kind of light. Lamp is a lamp. But to the writer, every mundane item triggers connections, and that leads to more. seemed like neither of us could bother to properly wipe the lampshades.
That happens.
All these metaphors and similes in my head. Light of my life. Make light. Well, that's another kind of light.
Ooh. I'm not gonna look in there because I know what's in there. It's a magazine with kind of an almost naked lady on it, and I'm not gonna look at that because I want this to be at least a little bit on the PG-13 part. Yes, I know I do a lot of swearing, but I draw the line on naked ladies right now. So if you want to know what's in there, you'll have to play it for yourself. Sorry, guys. I do have a limit. True friends stand by each other through any adversity. Aw, that's sweet.
No, I don't want to leave right now. There's still something for me in here. I better stay in case Serena comes back. There's always a chance she might return.
Maybe.
There's nothing for me out there.
Let's go over here. Let's park it. Let's look at the picture again.
We don't have a lot of photos of ourselves as a couple, so this one is quite important.
Very beautiful artistry on this, honestly.
The guy who snapped this? Our host that night? My love.
Okay. Ooh, music playing. Now what? Are things gonna change now? It changed.
Years passed, no tears fell. No death knell reached the golden shores they trod. Another love story without a happy ending.
So here's my question then. How is he not noticing the fact that this has changed?
Time works differently in the other world. She's gone, and even then I just keep reading. But it's always been my way of looking for answers. Processing information. I can think of worse ways. Weird mix of doggerel and artistry. The elemental imagery is evocative, but the language and structure, I've always been drawn to things that are kind of both good and bad at the same time. Is there anything worse than beautiful memories turning to dust?
I could think of many things, in fact.
I feel like I don't even have the strength to lift the lid. What once gave me so much joy now fills me with unbearable sorrow.
Poor bastard.
All those moments we sat at this table, laughing, smiling, simply looking in each other's eyes. This table has seen many happy times. The meals we shared, or when we just used to stay up late with a bottle of wine and talk. Oh, how we talked. I sure hope she comes back soon. We can sit down and discuss our problems, like we always did. We could always work things out. I could tell plenty of stories about this table. To be honest, I'm surprised it's still in one piece.
Indeed.
Come sit with me. I want to talk. There's something I have to tell you.
Oh dear. The plot thickens.
I have been trying, and believe me, I've been trying so hard.
I almost have it. What was she trying to tell me? Of course, we made love here, too. There was no place
to
have
it
hidden before things deteriorated. Someone said, work and love are the only things that ever really happened to us. Was it Freud or Marilyn Monroe?
Yes, I'm guessing.
And I've let my work destroy my love. Writing was so all-consuming for me. made so little headway in all this time. It all seems so meaningless now, drained of everything that made it worth reading in the first place. I didn't lend out my Necronomicon, did I?
That was a reference there. Oh my god, was that
a
reference?
All of hers are still here, too.
That's funny.
The dining table was well worn even when we acquired the cabin. You could tell from its appearance that it had been the centerpiece of many happy occasions. It's different. But that just can't be different.
And yet it is. And now it is more.
Am I going mad? Somehow she looks sadder than I remembered. Could I really have been so wrong? We don't have a lot of photos of ourselves as a couple. The guy who snapped this? My love.
Say that again.
We don't have a lot of photos of the guy who snapped this, our host.
She looks angry.
An actual film camera. It's a different world, big enough for a lifetime of mementos.
Okay. Something was supposed to change there, he thinks.
As always, I automatically went to the window side, and she took the one by the armoire. Some of her scent still lingers. What's the matter with me? I can't seem to remember even ordinary things. When was the last time you made love? Maybe if I go to sleep, I will wake up. There she'll be. Arms wrapped around me, the warm, passionate touch of her lips. I can't sleep. It feels as if I've been awake for ages.
Maybe you're dead. You don't know.
I don't sleep well without Serena next to me. Both of blood, I know it's my general state of mind. But I feel even more depressed near this armor. Guess I can't shake off the memory of my sweet Serena trying on her various garments.
Be honest. Does this dress show too much cleavage? I want only one pair of eyes on me.
How I miss her naked back when she was standing by this armoir. The perfect curve of her neck. Her firm bottom.
Wow. This guy really loved her, honestly.
I'm a casual dresser. No need to change clothes right here.
Okay, so what now?
My light's busted again. Can I come over to your side and read?
Let's face it. Her reading material is shallow, to say the least.
Indeed.
Don't let the bedbugs bite. I'm the only one allowed to do the biting here.
Kinky.
Dust everywhere. The amount of dust on it might make me hack up a lung. It's full of little scratches and gouges. Dust everywhere.
Okay, let's continue on.
There are no monsters under the bed.
Let's go back to the picture, see if anything changes on that, because I know she looked angry, so let's see what happens here. Let me look at it now.
My love, we don't have a lot of photos. The guy who snapped my love, we don't have the guy who snapped this, our host, then our dining table. I could tell plenty of stories about this table. To be honest, I'm surprised it's still in one piece.
Okay.
Comfortable spot in the cabin. Well, along with the bed, of course. A lot of rarities, and especially didn't lend out my Necronomicon dip. Without any activity, the corner feels cold. I'd give anything to see her standing here again, making coffee or sandwiches. I made my own too, of course, but it just made me happy to see. When she was happy, she'd hum her favorite songs as she put her in. can't remember the last time.
Feeling peckish, dear?
The stove looks like something from World War I.
Okay. Guess maybe I do have to look at it.
You seem to take fewer and fewer walks as the years went by. Everything around here is so familiar. Everybody thinks that living out in the middle of a dark, dense forest is so romantic. Nothing but you and nature. Serena and I thought so too, once. That is, until the loneliness kicked in. Why did you choose this place? We're both so young and spontaneous. Why did we suddenly decide we should let our love wither away in a still life?
Because living in the city sucks. That's why.
Crack in this window from a tantrum she threw some time ago.
Ugh. I'll try my best to, like,
not exactly
make sure it's, Anyway. I'll try and edit this so that you don't have to, so that I don't...
Remember when you ran... I feel too restless to sleep right now.
Okay, so... Glitch? What else am I supposed to do here?
I should leave the keys here until she comes back. Because I know she will.
Where are you going?
I said I'd be back, and here I am. I did come back. We did have a night prowler once. We left a mark. I never noticed it before, but there's some rust on the ring. Get a new one. She always reminded me to take these. I never asked her to. She just did it.
Well, that's the job of a wife, to make sure that her husband is not dying.
I've been so immature about these. Even resorted to the old pill under the tongue trick more than a few times. She deserved better. I tried to flush these a long time ago, but someone noticed. Caring about my infant life.
So angry. Let's go back over here. So it looks like everything just got darker. Hang on. Let's see what happened. Yeah, her face is angry now.
She's angry now. Part of me realizes I should be more shocked by this, but for some reason, I just feel numb. Beyond it.
This escalated quickly.
Lying to me and manipulating me all the time. Why did I let her do that? I'm the one who should have been scowling. She played me like a harp and made me look like a complete idiot. All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies.
So angry. Damn.
I couldn't care less about this damn thing. I torture myself trying to remember.
Sit down. We need to talk.
When did it go so wrong? This was supposed to be a... We weren't supposed to fight here.
Fighting happens anywhere.
You just don't get it, do you? You never do.
Too upset to even think straight.
Also, Sam.
I hate her so much. All of this... These pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies.
As far as you know.
I want to hurl the whole damn lot into the lake. Or just tear at the pages until the wind sweeps them away. Some of these started in mildew long ago. Nothing gold can stay. Frost. Words. Those damn words. My whole life's been consumed by them. Now I have none left to say.
Oh, yes, you do. You have more to say.
I couldn't care less about this damn thing. This armchair. This is where we had that talk. Damn.
I've been trying so hard, but we lost something along the way. Did you get my letter? Will you just listen to me for once? God, you're always... Wait, where are you going? Don't walk away from me.
Torture myself trying to remember. It's like looking into my own soul right now.
Yeah, that's what it feels like sometimes.
Did I see shadows move? No. Just my imagination. It's like the whole world is against me. Even my mind is playing tricks on me. Too upset to even think straight.
This should have changed and did.
Changeable man. Insolent wretch. Sounds like Serena, all right. Her father's realm. She was a daughter of the Celtic sea god Manannan. What was it? Maklura? Scholars say Niav's divine father, Manannan, is of an elder race even more ancient than the Tuatha De Danann.
Interesting.
I hate her so much.
Okay, let's look in here. Maybe now we can open this goddamn thing. Yay, we can open the goddamn thing.
I sit here on the train, taking me to my final farewell to the ones who brought me to this world. I see the smiling couples on their way to new adventures and think, it used to be us. We had joy and laughter and friends once, but a memory is not the thing itself. You're very good at letting things you don't want to face slip off you. You continue as if nothing has changed, lost in your own lifeless world. Words and dreams may be enough for you. You know what? You'll get a chance to test that soon. I question how I once saw things. How much of what I thought we had were my own feelings, and how much of your manipulation. Because you are so very good with words, aren't you? You knew how to use them when we met, and for the longest time, I went along with the romantic whirl you conjured up around our shabby, isolated existence. Oh, it took me long enough to see it for what it was. And there were these moments that you swept me off on foolish flights of fancy, when I threw myself into your fantasies. You wove your spell, plying me with your magic and with wine in equal measure, and I was taken in like the lost little girl I was. Do you realize all the pain you've caused me? They say if you have to ask whether someone loves you, you already know the answer. Protestations to the contrary can no more convince me anymore than I can make my own mother or father draw breath again. Your aloofness tells a different story.
Aloofness. So did he cheat on her then? That's what it sounds like.
I no longer know what you're thinking. With my parents gone and with your refusal to even accompany me in my time of need, something broke. Or maybe it happened long ago, but I never saw it so clearly before, even after everything. I don't make you feel comfortable? Really? That's all you have to say? I won't waste any more life waiting for things that'll never come. Of course, that's what you expect me to do. Play the good wife so no one will laugh at you for being the failure you are, to shield you from the truth of your existence. Lost
in
your books and vapid verse, blithely drifting into the mists of time, as if not even a footnote, when you could be raking at it if you'd only used your words for anything other than personal indulgence. You talked and talked about your path, the winter blueness of my eyes, all that nonsense. And the years rolled by, the seasons came and on, you pursuing your dreams that will never be. Lost in your damned words, looking for clues you'll never find. I'm sure you're doing it even now with your rotting books. You took the best years of my life and gave only empty words in return. We've gone as far as we can, and something's got to give. Us.
So goddamn angry, shit. Such angry people.
Just a bunch of schmaltzy junk. A shrine to naivety. See anything else of value. I should just destroy this useless junk. But not even the venom inside me gives me strength.
Actually, it doesn't.
These pathetic souvenirs from our relationship.
Picked up something.
Her jewelry box. What is it doing here? I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
Okay. So, I'll look at that later. Let's see here.
Somebody hurts. Nothing feels worse when there's no hope. No chance of anything. The light is so dim here. Makes me want to chop down every tree outside.
Don't take it out on the trees. They did nothing to you. Just because you're pissed off at your goddamn wife does not mean gives you the right to cut down the damn trees.
There's only a limited window of opportunity for everything.
Nice pun.
Waste of time. Don't torture myself trying to remember. That insane. incessant noise. I should smash this useless antique to pieces right now.
Then do it.
Do it.
I can't keep the time for 5 minutes straight. Chimes completely at random and never stops making that infernal noise. But hey, guess who thought it was so cute?
Damn.
This thing has caused me more sleepless nights than I care to remember. No wonder I'm going crazy. Too upset to even think straight. The stains on this bed suddenly make me mad. Angry even. Why must life always end up so sordid and hateful?
Because when you fuck up, shit like that happens.
I'm not crawling in there. I'm too riled up for that, and it's just not dark enough anyway. All the real color faded from it long ago. It must be full of dust mites. I should burn it. I told her the rug was fine work, like I know anything about handicrafts. But it's what the Empress wanted to hear, wasn't it?
Okay, I think I'm done with this guy's bitching. Let's see what's over here.
I should tear all her filthy, disease-ridden clothes apart and burn them!
Oh, yeah.
Everything she wore, just to lure me in. Not even these violent impulses give me the strength I need to open the armoire. What is wrong with me?
You're angry. That's what's wrong with you.
I hate her so much. How could I be so inconsiderate? Did this stupid lamp destroy my marriage?
No. No, you did that on your own.
I will fix it. In case she comes back. I haven't got any bulbs on me, and I didn't bring any tools. What am I thinking? Why am I worrying about a stupid lamp?
Because you're angry, yet you still love her, and you want to fix your marriage. That's why.
All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies. It's finally sinking in. She's not coming back. Nothing in this cabin will ever change again unless it's by my hand.
We don't have any more light bulbs. I'm sick of this thing anyway. We're chipping away at what little money we have because of a piece of junk.
I couldn't care less about this damn thing. Torture myself trying to remember. It's just a book. What good will reading a fairy tale do me? Stupid, feeble-minded woman for silly, menial things. God has never been there for me when I needed comfort. Why would he want to go out of his mysterious ways to help me now? It was she who didn't deserve me. I wouldn't waste my intellect on this sublunary distraction.
What a dick. God. It's almost as bad as finger bones with that asshole. I mean, they're probably related somehow. Either that or it's a descendant. I don't know.
She probably cared more for this plant than she cared for me.
Oh, that's bullshit.
Too upset to even think so. I hate her so much.
Okay, this guy's incessant bitching is pissing me off just a little bit.
I can't even bear to look at my face. She's already done a number on me.
You've done it on yourself, just saying.
Never descended to criticizing my looks, though. Even when we fought, even when my hairline started going, it was a sore point for me. My thoughts are all over the place. Together, damn it.
Never.
All of this, these pathetic. How could I have been so blind? Her vanity, always fixing her hair before bed, doting on her hair like a child. But I'm being unfair. Would I have wanted her to be some frump? Too angry to even care.
Poor peoples.
All she cared about was herself all along. Her needs, her feelings. That's all that ever mattered to her. What about mine?
Well, if you ignore her, you know, of course she's going to be, like, upset about her own feelings, you know? Just don't ignore people. Communication is key in any relationship. Any relationship. Key. Get it in your head now, boys and girls.
I couldn't care less about this damn thing.
We will save you someday. Trust me.
Where are you going? Oh, that's rich. Just run away.
I just needed to blow off steam to be somewhere else. Just for a while. But I can't even remember what we argued about. Unless she was the one who left. I'll torture myself trying to remember.
Maybe she...
She once told me how I supposedly used words to fool her somehow. But what did she think this stuff was? Natural?
Maybe. You don't know if the ingredients are natural or not.
How was I supposed to react when she used this anyway? She knew I loved her. It's not like we have to say it over and over again.
Yes, you do. Reassurance is a big thing. Especially with those of us who have anxiety and depression.
The smell of this disgusts me. So many lies, so much deceit. She probably left it here just to spite me. Too upset to even think straight. High blood pressure. What a load of bull. I've never felt better in my life.
I'm sick and tired of having to pamper you like a baby. Fine, I hope you have a great, lonely time at the hospital.
I hate her so much.
Dearest, and then you...
Remember the love you had. Good Lord. Whoa, ceiling. Whoa, everything. Whoa. Okay. Ah, got itch. Alright. And now... Let us sit.
All of this, these pathetic souvenirs from our relationship, they're all lies. I remember how happy these made her. She smiled. That wonderful smile. You must have gifted these to make amends or something. Or did I? Did I ever gift her anything? She loved her trinkets more than she loved me. Right?
No, you're just making excuses.
I couldn't care less about her wedding ring or mine. But what is it doing here? Oh, please, no. It's... hers. I can't believe she would just leave it here. Where the hell is she? True. No, I didn't do it. I need to wake up from this nightmare.
What do you think you did?
Torture myself trying to remember.
Push her away to the point where she's no longer, you know... your wife? Back over here. Ooh, nope, didn't have. What? Clothes. Oh my god, body. Okay.
It isn't. How did it happen? I can't remember.
Doesn't look female, though.
It's already rotten beyond recognition. How much time has passed? It's dry and withered. A body takes at least weeks to... How long has it been? I can't even remember how I did it. Maybe I didn't. Do I have brain damage? Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised.
Maybe that's you and you're dead. Just a thought. Right. And yes, there was voices there. Or maybe that was her. Who knows?
I would electrocute myself with that light.
I tried
to see that. That horror any better. Is there someone else? Hearing things. I'm not taking any chances by turning this on. I used to have some sleeping pills here. They're gone. Can't leave anything for a bottle of scotch. So many things wrong. Different. What happened? I remember none of it. Nothing. My own dark room. Barely alive. This, my eternal punishment? I wonder if this plant is poisonous. With my luck, it will just give me a headache.
No, it's not poisonous.
After Pavella died, you have a better fate for me. Is this purgatory?
Maybe.
Job, was it? Why did I not die at birth? For now I would have lain down and been quiet. I would have slept. I would have been at rest. To hell with this book.
Yet you read it.
Please, let me wake up. Let it be a dream. In that sleep of death, what dreams may come. I can't bring myself to close my eyes. I know I'll see her. What have I done? I remember stumbling on this more than once, but she always insisted it be kept here. She did it on purpose. This rug. I could wrap the body in it. No, I can't. I can't even think about this. It's grotesque. Red like blood. Yellow like dead eyes.
He's slowly starting to, you know, go a little bit insane there. Stopped clicking.
Would death guarantee if I...
Maybe.
I'm too much of a coward to try killing myself with this. No light. Only darkness. Time supposed to heal all wounds?
No, it doesn't. Talking it out heals, but not time.
I've really gone insane this time, haven't I?
Possibly.
I could swear time is standing still. How long must you suffer? The sun is a silent death for some. Dehydration, delirium. If I smashed the window, I could just slit my wrists with the shard.
Talk about major depression, Jesus Christ.
Bashing my head through might cut a carotid artery. Even quicker than the wrists.
Then again, it's understandable, considering he thinks he killed his wife. I'm tired of clicking on shit. There's so much more, but let's go this way. Kind of done clicking on so much crap. Still talking out there? Let's go to the door.
Those noises sound like more than one person. What can it be? Police? Are they coming for me? I deserve it, but I want to see who it is first. There's something about those voices. You must know. The window.
Do you realize how stupid this was? We had a plan. I took measures to ensure nothing like this would happen. But no, you couldn't help your damn self. We can't risk moving it now. The bulldozers are coming any minute.
Fire will do it.
Sounded like Serena.
It's been months since you...
Don't worry. It's all covered. We spent much time here.
Fine. Give me the kerosene.
There's a stain.
Oh, shit. You forgot your... Fuck. It was so stupid to leave it. Why did he do that?
Can you calm down? I couldn't bear to wear it any longer. It's in a safe place. We'll take it from the ashes.
No. Not like this. Please. No.
Wow, that's some fucked up shit. So... That was Serena. And I'm guessing that blood stain was actually from his head, and she was the one that killed him. So the plot is that she got upset as he was trying to walk away. She killed him and got help to get him into the closet. And so he just kind of rotted away, and that was him as a ghost. Only thing I can think of. Alright, so this was Serena. And, this was pretty cool, actually. Lot of things to click on, but, it's great. Great storyline, great atmosphere, just amazing, amazing artwork. So yeah, definitely check this out on Steam. Let me know also what you guys think of it too, you know, because... see if you guys got anything more out of it. So, I want to thank you guys so much for joining me in this video. Leave a like, share, subscribe, you know the drill. And as always, my minions, stay amazing out there and go do what you do best, all right? Peace.